Unsolved mysteries. The real problem with a small group of people who control these technologies unwatched by public eyes is its potential for great abuse. For example, we can never fully solve any accident or crime and know whether it was an EEG heterodyned crime or a regular one. Princess Diana's driver could have been EEG heterodyned and made to crash into the barrier. John Hinckley could have been made to believe that only by shooting President Reagan could he get Jodie Foster to love him. I met a colonel in the Air Force who test flew the new exotic airplanes and who was menticized after discovery of all sorts of corruption with Halliburton defense contracts. False memories were implanted in him and he was made to believe he was married and had a kid with some music star for 2 years. Clearly the capability exists to create Manchurians like John Hinckley. JFK Jr. could have been made to misinterpret the horizon or his aircraft instruments to malfunction. Flight 800's fuel tank could have been sparked by directed energy weapons. All these events could have been assassinations using EEG heterodyning and directed energy weapons, but we will never know. How can you have justice when one cannot be certain as to whose mind was behind the crime, or even if the jury or judge is being influenced? Clearly the current controls have failed and a major reorganization of the government is justified to regain constitutional controls over these weapons systems in order to restore justice, redistribute the power structure evenly again, and hold accountable high traders and special interest corruption from sidestepping the laws and constitution. The capability for directed microwave weapons and weak magnetic fields for silent assassinations with plausible denial is huge. Microwaves at specific power and waveforms have been shown to be able to cause diabetes through sugar metabolism changes or cancers by breaking a weak hydrogen bond in the DNA. All sorts of medical problems can be created with directed energy weapons besides just frying a person. The days of the CIA hitman have ended and replaced. Thank Reagan for giving them more power with a huge Star Wars initiative to fry a person rather than an incoming missile. It is proving to be the favorite weapon of the corrupt shadow agencies under the executive branch. I think the leaders have misinterpreted the word execute to mean murder and not operations. Stupid alien quotes. We'll tell you who ordered your torture and assassination. It was Colonel Casper. You know, he is like a ghost if you try to catch him. Ha 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 ha. Legal and ethical problems with Tammy's spy mode. In the current hive mind approach, much like quantum experiments, the observer is part of the experiment. Hence, the observer is partially responsible for the actions of the subject that he observes in unpredictable ways. This is truly a legal, moral, and ethical dilemma if it were used by law enforcement. Secondly, the data gathered by Tammy is just the cortex brainwaves and as such represents a perceptional interpretation or purposeful imaginary creation, and hence can't be trusted as accurate in a court of law, even if every person's lifetime brainwaves were recorded and could be played back as evidence. Politics of psychotronics. I want to know what went on behind the scenes with the Reagan/Gorbachev meetings that caused the nuclear missile reduction treaties but instigated the Star Wars defense initiative. Could it be that they created a treaty to co-develop mind control weapons as others have stated? Did the United States purchase the mind control weapons technology to bail the Soviet Union out of financial collapse and then develop it under the Star Wars defense budget as several historians have surmised? Many have speculated that Reagan's senility was a CIA menticization to keep him quiet about the technology. Bush Sr., being head of the CIA, certainly knows about it and has made many references to it in his speeches. Clinton was a pawn and helped sign non-lethal bills for continued testing of the weapons on the public. He only shouted right-wing conspiracy too late when blackmailed by sexual indiscretions. Bush Jr.'s spokesman has made his knowledge of the weapons quite clear during his threat to the Republicans, "You will suffer in your own private purgatories. Try to sleep if you can." He might as well have said, "Go to hell. Satan will be waiting for you." So the mind control, torture, and silent assassinations are still acceptable criminal behaviors by our leaders to order for personal gains. They either conform to this criminal norm or they will be assassinated like Kennedy if they try to reform the integrity of politics and inform the public. Real-time Nielsen ratings. Since our government is composed of different crime families, warlords, gangs, and mobsters all competing for power, money, and glory, one colonel often does not even know what the other one is up to. More or less, could Congress know what the black budgets really fund? One project that seems to have failed or at least hasn't benefited many presidents is the real-time opinion polls calculated by a sampling in the Mind Network. It is useful to groom a candidate into office, but it doesn't seem to be successfully used by the commander-in-chief while in office. Like the thousands of others in the United States psychotronic concentration camps, I was denied the chance to vote in the last election, which clearly would not have favored Bush. there may have been enough to swing the very close election had we not been brain-napped, tortured, and experimented on. Stupid alien tricks. To give you a better idea how the intelligence community lacks intelligence, I will share some of the aliens' misunderstandings of me. I use many different names under different circumstances and during different periods of my life. I do this to help me know where I know someone from. I separate my social groups into family, current friends, business, and old friends. My name has evolved in time with the different groups. So I can precisely tell who I am talking to by what name they call me. So one of the demonstrations the alien army like to do is voice transformation. They amazingly could mimic everyone in my family and few distant friends. However, they couldn't get my sister's voice correct for some reason. They would act out verbally abusive scripts using their voices, but they don't have a future in Hollywood. Not only did they get all their personalities wrong, they had every character use the wrong name when they would speak to me. This gave me an idea. I started feeding them a continuous stream of incorrect information. Days or weeks later, they would regurgitate it to me and pretend like they had a lot of intelligence gathered already. That was their game. Walk the target backwards in time with their memories using cues. This is a type of memory probing technique. Stupid aliens. Chalk one up for the humans. Human effects weapon testing industry. As difficult as it may be to believe, the United States has an industry based upon the population's inability to believe the horror that random citizens would give taxes to build weapons that would then be used on them in the most dreadful way. With this inability of the people to get involved or investigate, and through a carefully engineered common belief system, the human slave trade thrives in the United States and abroad. Poaching people from all walks of life for the EEG heterodyning and hive mind control experiments is lucrative business. The killing tools of our society have become better at what needs to be said for the population to ignore the problem and easily dismiss these claims. Without your voice and protest actions, more people by the hundreds if not thousands will be tortured to death over a long period of time. Everything is done to an extreme just so it sounds even more absurd when told by the test subjects. Discrediting is the game that has been perfected since the alien abduction stories are wearing thin these days. If the United States and CIA were to kidnap random people to test their M16 assault rifles, people would take notice. The body count would get suspicious. But by torturing and killing people through an advanced directed energy system that few understand or know about that just kills the mind with the body to follow slowly behind, nobody sees the immediacy of the atrocities and threat to the legitimacy of the government. Public service announcement. I know I will sound like a braggart, but my education in today's dollars cost over $1 million. The government has destroyed a $1 million brain. There is not a single person living with my exact pedigree or education. My entire life of hard work, hundreds of all-nighters, and enormous strain to better myself and invest in my mind has ended up as a decimal point for the CIA/military weapons statistics. I would love to do a public service message for kids. Drop out of school, live it up, do drugs, because there is a certain chance all your hard work will land you in the culture program and your personality will be altered, your happy outlook on life diminished, and your savings taken in a period of a few years while being tortured. They don't teach you that while growing up in America for obvious reasons. I've seen things you people wouldn't believe. Attack ships on fire off the shoulder of Orion. I watched sea beams glitter in the dark near the Tannhauser Gate. All those moments will be lost in time, like tears in the rain. Time to die. Replicant baddie. Blade Runner. Government homicides. Not very sporting to fire on an unarmed opponent. I thought you were supposed to be good. Replicant baddie, Blade Runner, 1982. I get told all the time when I discuss this book to people, aren't you afraid the government is going to kill you? With the best education money can buy, why was I not taught that the United States executive branch is corrupt and we accept this? I was taught to believe in the Constitution. I pledged allegiance to the flag every day in grade school. I was taught about all the valiant soldiers who fought to create a country with low taxes and less tyranny. We hold our hands over our hearts and listen to the national anthem at every sporting event. We put support our troops ribbons on our cars for a war we assume is necessary. We fly American flags outside our houses and buildings. I bought into the whole thing hook, line, and sinker. I was never taught to fear the management of the country because they are there to serve us and protect us. The truth needs to be taught in history books so people's expectations aren't as high for their stay in this land. The very people we put in charge to manage the country's affairs don't know the Constitution and certainly aren't there to protect it. George Bush's NSA domestic spying is just the tip of the iceberg. Since the politicians are powerless to create laws that protect us and certainly powerless to enforce them when broken by other government branches, we should just come to grips that the American dream is over and our country's values were stolen by crooks posing as CIA and DOD. Our right to freedom of speech has been nullified by information and psychological warfare tactics. Scream fire and people will come to the rescue. Scream rape, fewer people will respond. Scream government torture and assassination, no one will come to your rescue. Nor will it be published, nor will a major news medium pick it up. Try publishing it on the internet, disinformation agents will flood the search engine topics with garbage. Each of us is in an architected information bubble, isolated through informational noise and overload. Our right to privacy has been voided for many decades. The politicians purposefully lag 30 years or more behind current technology in lawmaking. So, for example, the Electronic Eavesdropping Act is far outdated and only applies to simple technologies. Reading brainwaves, clearly the most intrusive act government could do, is and will not be covered by these laws, nor are video camera transmissions. Privacy is an illusion too. Our right to life, liberty, and pursuit of happiness can be taken away at any moment if your weapons test and death lottery number comes up. Manipulation of events and people are common practice as well. You may have been caught up in a military exercise and never know the true reason why you got cancer, for example. I suspect we should expect more encroachment on our right to bear arms too. We should expect excessive double taxation as well to support the ever-growing war machine. Through our trust in our government officials' truthfulness and competence, we have allowed our country and its ideals to be turned into the very thing that we used to fear from communism or an autocracy. The war machine's culture is one of an autocracy. Of course, their values will seep into politics if they aren't deprogrammed after leaving the machine. It is extremely detrimental and dangerous to have a president or any politician who has had a career in the CIA or DOD if they haven't had time to reintegrate back into society. Right to a fair trial does not exist anymore. If people can be targeted to fail lie detectors, judges, and juries can be manipulated, then justice is void. If people can be targeted by the CIA or military assassins and this is acceptable, then justice is void. If people's brains can be killed or menticized, but the body kept alive for a while, then justice is void. Menticide is a pseudo-legal loophole which the government uses to disable and kill people. Making someone kill themselves is just a clever loophole, they believe. They are just redefining what self is. Overlapping someone else's mind using EEG heterodyning to commit violence against others or self is obviously a criminal act by the government psychic assassins and not the person who owns the body and brain. But without spelling out the obviousness of this in a law and having a separate army to enforce it, these idiots will continue to destroy American ideals and values. That was irrational of you, not to mention unsportsmanlike. Replicant Batty, Blade Runner. TSS services and CIA drug experimentation and subsequent mind rape and death is not different than scum who use Rohypnol to drug a girl then rape her while incapacitated and then worse by killing the girl to make sure there are no witnesses. This is now common practice by our government to develop weapons and more tricks for the CIA. Is there any doubt that international criminals have taken control? Just remember, if you served in the military forces, you supported these criminals and their intentions by believing in their lies. Don't blame yourself, how could know? Secrecy and knowledge compartmentalization allows for these kinds of crimes against countrymen and humanity to go unchecked and flourish out of control. The denial that people have about mind control technology is like the denial people have that they won't get addicted to a drug. It can't be that bad. I would notice. I could resist it. It doesn't work like that. You cannot resist it, and most people, unless trained, wouldn't even notice it. Your very essence, your brain electricity and neurotransmitter synaptic signaling, is being modified. You can't feel it being done because you think you are in control. You have an illusion of choice if you are EEG heterodyned by an experienced psychic spy. Can you see how easy a takeover was with this technology? No one is allowed to discuss this in public now without being silenced or discredited. I didn't know that when I happened upon the technology. Alien introductions. When the psychic parasites introduced themselves to me on that spooky Halloween 2004, they tried many introductions, but the one that seems most appropriate was, "We are the Borg. Resistance is futile. Your uniqueness will be assimilated. You are food for thought. And by the way, you need to slow down your thinking and think in complete words." Well, we know that aliens don't think in pictures now. I can only estimate how many people must be tortured by the directed energy weapons who never figure out why their body is falling apart and in pain all the time. Of the 6,500 people I have interviewed, about 25% were people who did not have the synthetic telepathy. They were not told each and every pain that was to occur or what government program they were being tortured under. I always ask the question of these victims, how did you figure it out? I would never have thought that my brain was being fed electromagnetic energy in such a precise manner that any programmed pain could be inflicted. I would have just come to the conclusion my nervous system was degenerating. The common response was, the pain occurrences and timing was too regimented and my limbs would twitch and almost move on their own like I was possessed. I went to the internet to do some research and found thousands of other people with the same story. Think how many people suffer the duration of their lives without ever finding a physical cause for their pain. It is staggering that these non-lethal nervous system disruptor weapons need so much suffering for their effectiveness data. Psychotronic slavery in the United States. The miserable have no other medicine but only hope. Shakespeare. Measure for Measure, Act 3, Scene I. Better than hope is a plan. The sociology of post-civil rights and post-Jewish Holocaust is an interesting one. I have had the opportunity to meet many hundreds of psychotronic slaves from all walks of life, age, sex, and religion. The mind control and slavery experiments are truly conducted at random on the most part composed of such diverse groups as children, nuns, upper crust wasps, and ghetto blacks. The types of people that seem to adapt to their new slavery status as human animals for DOD/CIA weapons testing are those groups that have had a heritage of being enslaved and children who haven't had enough freedom and self-determinism to miss it. Afro-Americans cope like they did before the civil rights movement. They usually create songs and protest peacefully like Martin Luther King in the many untelevised nationwide protests. Their expectations are not as high as Caucasians who believe and are taught they are entitled to freedom in America. The mind control data collectors often refer to themselves as handlers. I assume this is because they view themselves as animal handlers, training their pet projects. The Jews that I interviewed seem to not look for political solutions almost as if they aren't surprised fascism followed their people to America. They also are confused by the two-face policies enacted by the many divisions of government. The United States openly supports Israel, but then why are they torturing and putting Jews in these secret psychotronic concentration camps? They often don't realize it is random, and religion is not the discriminating factor in their decision this time round. The Muslims have the most anger about the unrecognized torture using this weapon system. Without access to the mass information streams, their stories cannot affect the American citizens' popular opinion. Like myself, many of the Muslims said that the agents introduced themselves as a satanic cult. This is done worldwide these days and clearly added to the Muslims' view that the United States is the great Satan. The European Parliament even said that these weapons should be banned because they are only useful in causing war and suffering. The tension and anger in the Caucasian group is also nearing a breaking point since peaceful protests have had little effect on making this a national and worldwide topic of debate. If and when violence breaks out, the news covers it up quickly as a crazed person or a domestic terrorist. The public never gets to hear the pattern of stories behind the acts. The Christians in the psychic torture concentration camps tend to be peaceful thinking too. They believe strongly that God would save them and that the United States is clearly on the path to hell. From the daily attacks and torment, they often get an apocalyptic view of the future. There does seem to be an inordinate number of women in the secret prisons. It may be that they are more outspoken about what is happening and men tend to cope silently. But the women mostly agree that they are targeted because the agents expect that they are weaker and less likely to commit violent acts against federal and military targets. Following this pattern, intimidation stalking is practiced at a far greater rate on women targets than men, furthering the proof that the zombieloids are part of a cowardly group. Quite an experience to live in fear, isn't it? That's what it is to be a slave. Replicant Batty. Blade Runner. Maintaining the loyalty of the regime. How did the United States agencies weed out all the high-ranking Russian double agents in the FBI and CIA back the 70s and 80s? They periodically check into the minds of agents to read their loyalties. Almost every DOD government worker with a clearance is on a fast rotational sample into their minds. This global human surveillance system, TAMI, has been readily expanding. The United States has a secret black budget of $42 billion that was leaked recently. At an average salary of $75,000, this pot of money could have a payroll of 560,000 agents of the United States government. How many of those are involved with this offshoot agency who handles the plausibly denied assassinations using Satan and truly unconstitutional mind-viewing surveillance is unknown. But one could estimate it to be anywhere from the early rumor of 400 people to 15,000 people in order to match and outdo the Russian psychic army. The Unabomber was just another mind-controlled patsy. This information is postscript the writing of this book. I found a connection between Ted Kaczynski, the Unabomber, and CIA mind control programs like I suspected existed. Apparently, they mind control a patsy to do their assassinations for them. I suspect the scientists to whom Ted sent bombs were connected with government grants dealing with some piece of the war machine that they didn't want further research into. My private research into virtual reality and EEG-controlled robots was probably one reason why I was chosen as the next patsy. Dr. Bird is one of the rare ex-military heroes in this story. He morally turned down working with Army intelligence when his mind-influencing research went black. He openly has discussed EEG telemetering and influence and found the LA Times article that describes Ted Kaczynski's participation in the CIA mind control experiments, moonstruck at Harvard. Sad that yet another innocent person is in jail for CIA mind control crimes. But the politicians are just too ignorant and stupid to pass any laws to spell out that this is unconstitutional and illegal. I take a personal interest in his case because it is so similar to mine. I lived in the same dorm that Ted Kaczynski lived in, Elliott House, at Harvard. I recognized his mindset, the evolution of mind control, isolation, then fear of technology. When I found out that there is actually a strong connection with the Moonstruck CIA mind control program, which validated my suspicions, leaves no doubt who the criminals are in the government. Similar links can be found with the Oklahoma bomber. People should be angry at the shadow government, not at the mind-controlled patsies that do their traitorous dirty work. The FBI are so simple in their textbook methods of investigations. They stop investigating once they find the body that committed the crime, in this case the body that mailed the bombs. They don't follow through to find whose mind did the killing. They never really have solved any of these mind-controlled murder cases correctly. We have the innocent person's body imprisoned, and the guilty murderous mind still free. Where is the justice in that? They just move to another target to continue their murderous streak and silent assassinations with plausible denial by using so many levels of indirection. Before I was grabbed for these brutal experiments, I was looking into joining the FBI's white-collar and high-tech crime division. I would have been good at it seeing that I have correctly solved at least 8 of their cases in less than 2 years of research, with no authoritative power to interview, and no budget. One must ask if it is incompetence or purposeful cover-up ordered from the top. Now this is my strong opinion on the topic. The FBI has been manipulated by the executive branch throughout history from Nixon to Clinton. Many victims are led to believe the FBI are the ones stalking them and torturing them. First off, if they were involved deeply they would not have allowed a federal building to be blown up with their agents inside by the Oklahoma bomber. My handler's third identity after Russia and China was the FBI to redirect my anger. Too obvious a decoy. I have no doubt that fake FBI badges may be used in these manipulations and that the CIA or other sub-intelligence agencies have infiltrated the FBI with a few corrupt agents just like the California Highway Patrol and other places, but I saw the woman FBI agent who helped catch the Unabomber speak at the college at which I was teaching. She was clueless and uninformed as to anything beyond police detective protocols. Even though the FBI was involved in investigating terrorist phone numbers dialed from my father's house, they were still just being manipulated again into following protocols so that if the agents succeeded in turning me into another Ted Kaczynski they could say look the FBI found a lead that he was connected to Al-Qaeda's or something like that. The public being stupid and seeing it speculated on the news would of course jump to the predetermined conclusion that there was a connection. The end. I get locked up for a mind-controlled EEG cloning crime unjustly like Ted Kaczynski or put to death like the Oklahoma bomber and as the CIA manual states, disposed of by local authorities. That's how the games are played. Good thing the DOD and CIA are so predictable, unchanging, and uncreative with their plots. Plus, I must have faith that there is hope in regaining constitutional control of our country and without the good intentions of the Justice Department all is lost. Creating mind-controlled assassins that is terrorists and psychos. Having nothing, nothing can he lose. King Henry VI, Act 3, Scene 3. It is very important that I preface what I am about to convey to the public so as I am not set up for more trauma and injustices by government agencies. What I am about to tell is merely to educate the public and the world as to the ways in which the United States preferably assassinates people these days. I am not a threat to commit the acts that I am about to describe. I am trying to help any do-gooders still left in the FBI or other positions of the Justice Department by explaining in clear terms the psychological methods the CIA and others use to create domestic terrorists and the reasons behind it. This information may diffuse future psycho outbreaks if it can reach other targets before they act. Like I mentioned before, I have not had a chance to interview Ted Kaczynski to find out the details of the mind control experiments conducted on him and to test him with the angles of eye gaze psychotic movement and a questionnaire I developed to quickly identify targets of EEG heterodyning mind manipulation. One form of assassination technique the crime family, CIA, like to use is to instill a hatred towards the scientists, retired military personnel, and the like who may leak these details of this weapon to the public and make them aware of the grand scam. The best-kept secrets are hidden in plain view. That is the case here. The stakes are high for the traitors in the government because the public outrage and distrust would topple the power structure or lead to a state of emergency from the riot outbreaks. So, they use patsies and complicated behavior and opinion manipulation tactics. For example, they attempted to turn me into a Unabomber-like assassin through extreme torture and planting the idea to get revenge on the most outspoken scientists and colonels in the field. Now, had they succeeded, they would have sent a strong message to all those who work on directed energy, EEG cloning weapons to keep quiet and never work on neuroscience again if you leave a government project. They also would have plugged potential leaks even if those people would have never talked. And in order to kill two birds with one stone, I, like my Navy/US/UK compatriots that were knocked off after leaving a secret project, would also have been silenced due to a suicide-like attack mission to end my suffering and get revenge, or imprisoned and possibly kept in solitary. As the CIA scripts say, the target after committing the crime will be disposed of by local authorities. This technique has been used many times throughout history and they just keep getting better at it. Like I advised earlier, everyone who has left a secret project might be able to save their lives if the information that the CIA/DOD are trying to contain is leaked. I wish I had known this and done it myself before I was targeted. It is pointless once you are targeted and it would just be used against you. John Alexander and Dr. Delgado are clearly pointed to the most frequently in the literature and some disinformation websites created by the agency. They have very deep involvement in the development of these weapons and it is obvious why the agency wants them eliminated before they get old, senile, and start telling stories. The question I have for Ted Kaczynski is why did he choose the targets that he did? Why did he believe he could stop this by disabling those particular scientists? What government connections did those scientists have in their past or present? Were they civilians working on science that the Pentagon secretly restricts but who can't exactly put out a list of prohibited knowledge acquisition? My conjectures have proven extremely accurate during this investigation and I believe I already know his answers. To further this tragic and incredible true tale, I will reveal why I didn't become another Unabomber in order to assassinate selected scientists and colonels that they tried to program me to. 1 year almost to the date before my abduction and brain napping, my father told me that FBI agents visited him and asked about two phone calls 2 years prior that were to known terrorist camps in Oregon. They came with their guns showing from Boise, Idaho's FBI office. The phone calls were from both his personal office and his wife's office in their home according to the phone records from the telephone company the agents said. Now I must remind you that I come from the perfect all-American family with only doctors and lawyers for all my relatives and many worked in the Navy. My uncle is the CEO of a major financial institution that issues paychecks to the military. My father's property is guarded by dogs and the house is many acres away from a security gate with an alarm system, and they have a daughter that is home all the time. It would have been impossible for someone to have broken in and dialed one phone call from each phone line. Given a background check, the FBI should have immediately realized that the records had been tampered with. Who has access to the phone networks at the base trunk? Only government agencies could have altered those phone records. When I was assaulted, psychotronically imprisoned, tortured, and attempted to be programmed, it was immediately obvious to me that an agency was planning a setup. So had they been successful at turning me into that psychopath, they could also have leaked to the media that my family had been questioned a couple years earlier with regards to a terrorist cell. Nice cover up, eh? Honestly, had it not been me, they would have succeeded. I must credit the immutable values that my educational institutions instilled in me and my singular model of reality that has never wavered. But, I am only one survivor. There are thousands of others in the United States that could be triggered into perceived terrorist attacks given any command if they are not separated from the killing signal. No government agency has even lifted a finger to stop this nor the media to expose it. I and others have vowed to do everything in our power to expose the criminals in the government. I am personally offering a $50,000 reward and immunity to anyone who will testify and finger their commanders. It is a very unfortunate trend in our government that both Congress and the Justice Department have been marginalized in their influence and autonomy. Without giving Congress an army of their own and direct access to all black ops projects, technologies, and strategies, we should not expect that they can help prevent the inevitable conclusion of this 50-year trend line. The Justice Department is supposed to be independent, the third pillar to stabilize a federal government from devolving into tyranny, authoritarianism, and some other form of fascism under a familiar name. There are laws to prevent the CIA and NSA from operating in this country due to McCarthyism. We never learn and history repeats itself. Without the scientific expertise of DARPA scientists and high-end military sensor systems, how can the FBI expect to prove this case to the public assuming they operated honorably and autonomously? In addition, the FBI have somehow been usurped under the executive branch and been illegally commanded and used by presidents like Nixon and Clinton. Integrity, honor, and honesty are rare qualities in the current system of controls. There are several other techniques of behavior modification and mind manipulation that the psychic assassins and conventional brainwashers use to create assassins, because when it comes down to it, they, as a group, are too cowardly to find anyone in their agency to perform the hits themselves. Of course, the plausible denial through many levels of indirection and high technology is a plus for those cowering in the shadows. These criminals, who can be linked all the way back to the commander and chief, do not want to be caught with beyond reasonable doubt connections through the chain of corruption. Why mind-controlled assassins? First, like in the movie Manchurian Candidate, people of the same race as the country whose leader the United States is targeting can more likely get closer to them. Secondly, it is a way that these rogue agencies rationalize how they are creatively getting around laws such as that the United States cannot assassinate foreign leaders. Instead, one level of indirection somehow makes it legal in their small minds. They think assassination through modulation of neurotransmitters in someone else is not linked back to their intention. Also, the overdone plausible denial that the person was crazy seems to always work. They really need a new act and some better script writers. It is a great way to get countries to war against each other and bring instability to regions like the Iraq/Iran war and Israel/Arab and India/Pakistan conflicts. We look like the good guy by simply providing weapons and pretending we support one side or the other. Of course, it often backfires when the countries figure it out and then go after the instigator. Why are people who work for a DOD/CIA project such a security risk after they leave? Well, Russia and possibly China have the mind-reading radar. So killing ex-employees of secret projects ensures that their minds can't be read and secrets leaked. So all current employees and ex-employees are at risk for Satan-style assassinations. I know of a victim who lives near me that was working for the Jet Propulsion Laboratory when they decided she needs to be tortured with psychotronics. She is still alive. So if you haven't made the mistake working for the government yet, don't. You will increase your chances of avoiding being thrust into hell. It doesn't make you immune, because after all they must not allow the statistics to be too convincing and have an obvious pattern, but the data seems clear enough from the 500 sample points I have. The making of a Unabomber. The similarities between Ted Kaczynski and myself are too coincidental to be written off. The agents chose someone from the same profile that worked so successfully before. It is a good thing the machine is so uncreative and predictable. So my guess is they used the same techniques on him that they used on me. Here are the steps involved in the psychological programming that the CIA uses to create Unabombers, Oklahoma bombers, and domestic terrorists. Hopefully this knowledge will defuse future bombers. After the ultra steps of programming and the biocommunications weapons data is collected, they progress to the final stage, which is to eliminate and further discredit their psychotronic hostage. The preferred method is to use them to attack targets of their choosing. Clearly the FBI should be angry at the CIA/DOD for killing many of them by sending the Oklahoma bomber after a federal building. Many of these mind control weapons test victims thoroughly believe the FBI is behind it. Even two ex-FBI agents who are test victims believe the FBI is behind it. I don't. They tried to first direct my anger at the Chinese government, then the Russian government, then the FBI. Traditionally there has been an animosity between these two groups in the government. The CIA views the FBI as a bunch of dumb glorified cops with none of the technology that they have. The FBI views the CIA as a bunch of criminals with no policing authority. Creating the psychology to make a programmed assassin, CIA terminology, has been perfected over the decades from the Kennedy assignation to the Unabomber. It is a very advanced mix of technology, psychology, and acting out scripts. The psychological strategies are truly astounding in these operations. Everything is geared towards plausible denial. The entire operation of testing and tortures hangs on one thread, and that is the majority of the population will not comprehend or believe the scale and brutality of these biocommunications weapons tests. They must be able to tell the mass news agencies with some evidence that the person has a history of mental illness and that's why they did what they did. That story is usually well received, and the FBI and people are content with that answer. It's simple. The truth is, the world is far more complex, and the games of belief system manipulation are a pure science. With just a combination of wireless torture and the inability for the target to get their story out and believed, leads to a frustration and panic at the discovery that everything is controlled in the United States and the constitutional system was stolen many decades ago. People handle this situation differently. Most run to the police, FBI, or even the White House lawn thinking they will find help. Instead, that just begins the process of creating a mental illness track record to be used against them later. Next, the handlers isolate their project using several methods. Isolation is necessary to further the delusional thinking without feedback from other people. Isolation also acts like a sensory deprivation chamber and increases the biocommunication signal strength through the phenomenon I discussed previously. The hypocrisy overthrew democracy but took its name. The secrecy surrounding this project, Tammy, is incredible. Clearly, the public would be outraged if it knew Americans by the thousands were being tortured and killed for development of military and CIA weapons, and that their brains are being spied into on occasion, not to mention that a thought-reading echelon-like project was well underway to automate the whole process, a clear violation of constitutional rights in every case. But that is the way American government has always conducted itself since World War II and Project Paperclip, which smuggled in hundreds of Nazi scientists. It usually takes about 20 years before the documents are released under the Freedom of Information Act. If there are any survivors, the current president apologizes to them. This is just the pattern and the way our government lies, without any punishment to them or justice to the victims. Just remember that America was torturing thousands of people when it said it had to go into Iraq to save the people from torture by Saddam. Remember that when Bush went to China to ask them to be nicer to their people, the shadow government was busy torturing thousands in Iraq and thousands in the United States and a few hundred in other countries with psychotronics. Then after we went into Iraq, we torture and kill lots of Iraqis, all in the name of democracy and freedom. Sad how easily people forget. After having experienced the potential of this weapon to be used to torture entire populations without end, I assure you that I'd rather die in a nuclear blast than endure pure pain without relief of death for years. The United States will not sign the UN ban on mind control weapons nor other international treaties. Russia even proposed the ban. If the United States doesn't have these weapons, then why not sign the treaties? Who is the real threat to the world? Who has more weapons of mass destruction than any other nation? And we somehow justify invading other countries out of fear they have them. It's pretty easy to see the shell game. Is fear of pain worse than pain? Do people fear death because they fear the pain involved with death? Then making the public obsess with terrorism while torturing thousands of its own people with pain weapons seems like the worst thing any government could do to its own citizens. Walking them to gas chambers like the Nazis did would be more humane. To try and get a grasp of how far behind civilian researchers are, I contacted many top neuroscientists in academia and microwave communication experts around the country. Less than a handful were even aware of Dr. Lin's work at the University of Illinois, and the very well-known abroad and published by the World Health Organization microwave hearing effect. Russian scientists coming to this country have commented on our population's ignorance of bioelectromagnetic non-thermal interactions. How could such important medical research be suppressed? It is a combination of the power of Dodd funding and systematic suppression of knowledge by other organizations. Another one of my heroes, a futurist and famous entrepreneur, Kurzweil, wrote a book called The Age of Spiritual Machines, which I thought to be an insightful look into one possible future. However, most people have not taken into account the political trends and e.g. heterodyning mind control technology when prophesizing the future. Rather than building costly robots and giving them consciousness, we are trending towards creating humbots, human robots, and removing the souls of men. It's an unfortunate turn for the worse in terms of an interesting productive future of technological innovations and their meaning for free-thinking humans. Some interesting interviews. All the people on which are being weapons tested endure enormous, unending suffering that takes a toll on their mental and physical health, so I preface the stories with that context, but there is a funny side to the mind games that are played with people. My interest in physics as a child evolved out of magic. The challenge of trying to figure out how an illusion is performed without being told was a thrill that has stayed with me for life. I have become quite good at it, as there are nearly no black boxes for me to reverse engineer anymore, from electron scanning tunneling microscopes to some of the highest end top secret weapon systems. Plus, this is a good time for a break from the macabre, morose truth of our currently dilemma in Americans' history. Stupid alien tricks. One guy from Taiwan was tricked into believing that there were tiny, invisible agents of the Taiwan government that could slip under doors, fly around, beat him up and speak into his ear. He describes the acts of these tiny, almost invisible agents in great detail. A judge in the Philippines thought that little dwarfs were his friends who he heard and would tell him how to rule on his cases. You can see why people come to these conclusions. Yes, they sound crazy. They are just incorrect with what they were led to believe. The perceived speech and agents behind it are real but can be located anywhere on Earth. However, the agents are all the United States paid and not connected with the local security agencies that people from other NATO countries are led to believe. One of the reasons many targeted people believe that the unseen people behind the attacks are small or dwarfs is because the voices perceived from the synthetic telepathy and microwave hearing effect are often very high, like the people are on helium. I don't know what causes this. If this book manages to gain any notoriety in the press or public gossip at large, most in the divisions of government that I brazenly reprimand will be scratching their heads and wondering whether I am telling the truth. Most in the CIA/DOD/FBI/legislature are clueless and trained to ignore people with these claims without thinking or educating themselves about it. Even an assistant Harvard professor recently published a book called Satanic Panic after interviewing 50 people for it. They were outraged at her conclusions, but she is trained in classical psychology and ignorant of these high-end physics weapon systems and the history of inhumane testing on large numbers of the public. She has accidentally done a disservice to our community by using her status to perpetuate the programmed belief of her community. Creating delusional thinking. The strategies for creating delusional thinking are also cleverly complex, but the simplest method is for the EEG cloned handlers to implant an idea hypnotically, overtly, or subliminally in such a way as to make the target believe they came up with the idea. Then the handlers reinforce that path of thinking. With no other sources of reality to error correct, the project can be led into extreme beliefs and actions in order to seek revenge, to save the country or human race, or to alleviate the constant psychological and perceived physical torture. In my case, after it became clear I wasn't prone to delusional thinking nor easily programmed to assassinate the usual targets that they suggest to the projects, they tried to use the same psychology that must have triggered Ted Kaczynski. Like I said, I have not had an opportunity to interview him yet to see if I am right. The next targets that were chosen were exactly the same group as I remember reading about Ted's case, scientists and military personnel who worked on these weapon systems, technology, or psychological techniques. The names are unimportant, but the target group is of interest here. They are trying to use the cover story of psychopaths to assassinate people who have certain knowledge and expertise in this field and might be used as witnesses in the psychotronic treason trials, with the additional benefits of slowing civilian progress on these discoveries, and of course disposing of the target by local authorities. The truth is, Ted Kaczynski was not the mind behind the crimes of which he was found guilty. He should be deprogrammed and released from prison immediately. After the psychotronic torture investigations and hearings. If it turns out after congressional investigation, people like Colonel Alexander had part in the conspiracy to test on and torture thousands of Americans or maintain that secret, he and many other will be charged with treason. Colonel John Alexander helped organize the Council of Foreign Affairs, which formed the Joint Non-Lethal Weapons Directorate under Marine budget. By classifying radio frequency weapons under the non-threatening title of non-lethal weapons, they have lumped weapons of torture in with rubber bullets, tasers, and glue guns. The Council of Foreign Affairs recommended that all non-lethal weapons be tested on men, women, and children. Who would donate their children for testing? In my investigations, I found several children being tortured by these weapons. Entire families destroyed and barely able to function under non-stop microwave hearing harassment and psychotronically induced pain signals. This is nothing short of criminal and treasonous behavior in a democracy. While I agree with many of Alexander's views, he is limited in his strategic thinking when recommending psychotronics-based weapons as a solution. He says in one interview, that if the United States doesn't weaponize space, other will. This will lead to space wars that will lead to space being a military battlefield littered with space mines, debris, and particle waste, making it unusable for continued commercial ventures. In his novel with Tom Clancy, Non-Lethal Weapons, he shows his willingness to deceive the public. He talks about an M device that stops bullets from sparking when the firing pin hits the metal that causes the gunpowder to ignite. He claims no one knows how it works. This one discovery of the uses of controlled energy is the foundation of which led to an imbalance of mad, mutually assured destruction, through nuclear missiles. Directed energy weapons can knock out the electronics and guidance systems or stop the explosive from igniting so that it doesn't continue into nuclear fission, which is needed as a precursor to fusion. This is why all new silicon chips have rad-hard specifications. During the investigation, we should expect records to be destroyed and shredded to further the cover-up. Many of the scum will be found in the CIA. The Deputy Chief of Staff for Intelligence in the Army said of the CIA, "They are the biggest assembly of liars and thieves this country ever put under one roof, and they are an abomination." P.300 Psychic Warrior, David Morehouse. Colonel Bearden is another outspoken person on this technology. He was trained in Western physics but speaks and writes about ridiculous explanations in a very non-traditional vocabulary. I can only imagine he is a confused psychotronic victim himself, or part of the group tasked to spread bad physics and disinform the public. Nazi Germany. Is the United States making the same mistake Nazi Germany made by starting wars on too many fronts? Why are we attacking people around the globe with these weapons? First, the weapon's effectiveness is based on language and culture specifics, even though Satan's interface is not. The other reason is that they need to keep any statistical anomalies of mental illness and popular delusions from standing out in one geographical area. So the instigation of hatred for the United States is partially intentional and partially accidental. We have Bush telling China that they are evil for torturing their people. We have Dick Cheney provoking Russia recently. We have Bush call 4 different countries the axis of evil. We the French who can't stand us. And the list goes on. Nazi Germany made a similar mistake by starting too many wars on too many fronts. Judges controlled. I have interviewed so many people that I can recognize all the variations of the weapons testers' scripts. Just in case people doubt what I say when I talk about that the justice systems have been marginalized like Congress, through the existence of this weapons system without constitutional controls. A judge in the Philippines was just recently relieved of his duties because he believed he was psychic, let his little dwarf friends make the determination of guilt, and became a believer in the Book of Revelations, which he quoted often before trial. His name is Judge Florentino Floro, presiding over a court in Manila. The reason he believes he has dwarf friends is that the synthetic telepathy and microwave hearing effect is often perceived by victims as high-pitched voices that sound like they are on helium. He is about a quarter way through the mind control experiments and clearly has no clue what is being done to him. My handlers love to brag about how many doctors they have destroyed who couldn't figure out how it was being done to them. Subliminal messaging. Buckaroo Banzai is a spoof on evil aliens that have taken control of the United States. When the heroes put on their special glasses, they see subliminal messages on top of billboards and other places that say obey your government. Do not question authority. Conform. These experiments on humans since the 60s have been misinterpreted or metaphorized differently by almost everyone and inspired countless movies. Once you are awakened to the brutality and psychological manipulation tactics of the so-called shadow government or evil aliens, whatever you prefer, you see how the drones are controlled as they go to and from work and watch countless hours of the hypno tube to learn what their opinion is supposed to be. When you are that drone, it is a happy sheltered bliss. But your life and goals are all based on false purpose, assumptions, and trivialities that if you knew would leave you empty. That is the zirconium with which the alien crooks replace the diamonds of true freedom. If you can't tell the difference, you will value it just as much until you try to cash in on it. Desperately needed legal modernizations. Amend Constitution to include freedom of thought. Amend right to free speech to include preventing government from purposefully drowning out truth with disinformation campaigns. One of the most credible sources of admission to the existence of these weapons besides the general that stated, "That's a sensitive topic," when presented with evidence and questioned about it, is the original document of the Space Preservation Act before its modification and subsequent passing. See Appendix A with a copy of this document and note how the elimination of the phrase psychotronic and mind control weapons be abolished from space was removed from the final version. For a country that respects freedom of speech, and more importantly freedom of thought, it seems obvious that we need these additional protections, especially in light that they are being used to manipulate the political process and the justice system. Time is running out in stopping a dark Dostoevsky-like future. The Electronic Eavesdropping Act desperately needs to be updated to include video transmission and brainwave activity, not just electronic listening devices. there is an imbalance of forces in the three-prong government due to the sly power junkies and their technology in the executive branch of government that threatens to undermine the checks and balances and safeguards intended by the designers of this country. Bounty on their heads. There is a bounty on the heads of these corrupt agents, subcontractors, and military leaders that are testing and using this technology on American citizens. It keeps growing. Currently, I am offering a $50,000 reward for information leading to the successful prosecution of anyone involved in these activities. Go to the website www.thematrixdeciphered.com to leave information. So if you are involved and want immunity from prosecution and a hefty reward, you will come forward to testify against Ultra program members and government psychotronic abusers. Strategy of controlling societies both in the United States and abroad. There has been many strategies published by the war colleges about how to use informational warfare tactics to control a society. The Russians have had similar strategies published since the 70s. The basic principle is to control the people of influence and the information streams. You only need to control about 10,000 people to do it extremely effectively in a country like the United States. More evidence of the cover-up of microwave effects. Even a thorough and superbly written report on sterilization techniques for food preparation written by the FDA astutely commented on the bizarre lack of human and bacterial effects of ionizing and non-ionizing microwave radiation. We are bathed in microwaves from cell phones, to satellite telemetry, to direct TV. Why the blackout? The reasons and research is too scary for the population to know about. Remember the mobile phone panic that ensued after some reports on significant increase of cancer risks? Telecom stocks fell in half. Well, there is a more diabolical motive for suppressing the research in this area since the DOD is very active in microwave weapons and their biological effects. Government crimes. As unbelievable as it may sound, these torture and mind control, Ultra-like, human experimentation programs involve far more than just tests as the name implies. Using some obscure laws in a loose interpretation, the DOD is allowed to perform non-consensual weapons experiments on the public at random. This is just a formality. They would do it anyway and justify it like President Bush has with secret NSA spying, it is in the name of national security. Besides breaking all the codes in the Geneva Convention and Nuremberg codes by torture script testing, they have attacked whistleblowers ignoring whistleblower protection laws. They have many attempted murder violations and successful murders using the mind control weapons. They break the subliminal slash hypnotic practice laws. They flagrantly and boldly break stalking laws. They have caused enormous damage to victims' personal wealth, health, and property during these tests of unending duration. They have committed many acts of murder and violence using other people's bodies. Then, of course, they are breaking eavesdropping and privacy laws. They have falsely imprisoned thousands of people in psychotronic prisons. But of course, if all was known, they have committed treason beyond any reasonable person's interpretation of the word. The list could go on for several pages. Amazingly, local and state police are clearly not sophisticated enough to understand these complex crimes. The FBI does not have the scientific talent on staff nor the expensive equipment to competently investigate this. Several of their own that I have interviewed have even become victims of the program. The former head of the LA FBI and a special agent of international terrorism. They are very outspoken, but of course their testimony is suppressed like the thousands of others. Are you scared yet? DARPA scientists and other agencies have been instructed to keep out of military exercises. Who's left to stop them? Possibly, an independent Congress Commission task force is the only hope without another country's intervention. I have never been political and never believed in conspiracy theories. But like in the movie The Matrix, it is so unbelievably pervasive and difficult to describe the complex electromagnetically architected world of psychotronics, you have to see it for yourself to believe it is going on. Anti-psychotronic theory. Prevention and solutions to brain interfering technologies. The truth is out there. X-Files. In the X-Files solution, they mention that a new race immune to the effects of the black oil is being cloned from alien biomaterial and human ova. This race will avoid the eventual mind enslavement. When translated, this would mean that the agents, whose cover story is evil aliens, are EAG cloned into the new race of cyber hive mind hybrids. The justification for brain-napping the population and putting them on the TAMI mind surveillance network is to make sure no other countries are controlling or spying into their minds. However, as with most Hollywood interpretations of the psychotronic Holocaust, it incorrectly describes who the enemy is. In this case, the so-called immune race is actually the mind slaves. they are immune because they are already infected by the black oil. How and why movies and TV series like The X-Files or Outer Limits are created to subtly tell an unspoken truth is beyond me. I wish I understood why hints for the justification of the evils of the government are somehow conveyed to the mass programming media. Is it to clear their conscience or arrogant mockery? Or maybe it is a discrediting tactic used against those who dare come forward to speak about it. Jammers, detectors, shielding, oh my. The vaccine against the black oil. The black oil is symbolic of the black sciences and the electromagnetic signals that are forced into those mind-controlled or zombified by Tammy, mind, or Satan. The evil aliens in the X-Files was symbolic of the Russians or the United States Department of Defense, and the timeline for takeover is a reference to the bioelectromagnetic weapons arms race we are in. I speculate that the secret vaccine that the X-Files solution speaks about is a bioinformationally incoherent signal so that people's brains don't learn to interpret an EEG cloning attack signal. The crack that the CIA sold to black neighborhoods supposedly to fund the Nicaragua rebels served a dual purpose, and that is creating a whole new generation of psychics to catalog and clone. Crack and methamphetamines cause damage to the dopamine reuptake receptors, thereby leading eventually to psychosis. As I mentioned before, amplification of electromagnetic signals occur at much lower power levels with synapses flooded with excess neurotransmitters. The Air Force documents I discovered for research into non-lethal weapons was testing for neurotransmitter release under different microwave frequencies. This research is either another method of nervous system influence, or they are looking for an electromagnetic way to flood the brain with neurotransmitters rather than by natural or chemical means to increase EEG cloning effectiveness. I have not been able to validate that the Prozac craze, SRIs, serotonin reuptake inhibitors, has any effect on the increased effectiveness of TAMI or the electromagnetic influence of those neurons involved that use that neurotransmitter. However, higher levels of dopamine are very much desired for the voice-to-skull, synthetic telepathy, to be effective. It takes much smaller nudges electromagnetically to create word recognition or amplify thoughts. As a bonus, people with increased dopamine levels would be cake to discredit. It can be done to anyone even within average dopamine levels, but slightly higher power levels are required. Since the beamwidths from the large fields of phased arrays are still very broad, the potential exists that several people in an area would learn the same signals, and that would be problematic to the secrecy. This is also why identical twins, couples, and entire families end up being targets if they live together. Scrambling the informational coherence of the biocommunication signals. Like how Star Trek defeated the Borg, shields need to be modulated in order for the signal not to be informationally coherent to a brain. The adaptive algorithms will adjust to any stable frequency domain background noise. This is a form of Fourier filtering. The adaptability appears to have a 6-degree of freedom function. So a semi-chaotic changing modulation of electric and magnetic fields should stifle the forced brain learning and insertion of the sixth sense. Their adaptation requires a pattern that they follow to filter, so it needs to be led continuously to chase a white rabbit of noise. This is the basic theory behind scrambling the signals to the target brain, which will over time unlearn how to interpret the signal with this additional noise. Psychic defenses and war games. The brain mapping has limitations. The kind of neurological information that is cloned is constrained due to bandwidth and resolution limits. Many test subjects incorrectly describe that their invisible attackers can see through their eyes, and then falsely conclude that microchip implants have been placed on their optic nerves. Only the higher level cortexes are mapped onto the psychic observer, like the audio and visual cortex, for example. They can see only your mind's eye and not the raw output of the optic nerve. So if a target knows they are being spied upon, they can imagine false images that do not correlate with the actual optical view, and thereby transmit false data back to the psychic spies with some practice. Similarly, the audio cortex can be misrepresented by imagining false sounds or conversations. However, one cannot block real audio input from being gathered, because the raw output from the cochlea can be measured in the EEG called the BEAR, Brain Auditory Evoked Response Test. More stupid alien tricks. It is a fair comparison to call these psychic soldiers chimps. When they are panicking their victims, to whom they say they are going to cause a heart attack and a stroke, they literally thump on their chest and stand on their heads to cause the sensation of increased blood pressure in the brain. The thumping on the chest feels like arrhythmia and skipped heartbeats. These dumbasses aren't even Neanderthals, they never evolved to humanoids. National defense lie. More disconcerting in these experiments that have been marketed to the black budgets as national defense, is that there is no defensive action about these weapons. If the government were truly trying to protect its citizens, they would be building superconducting shelters within the nuclear shelters they already have for the citizens. There are several high-tech defenses against neurological weapons that they are not sharing with their bosses, the taxpayers. With our own money and resources, we are covertly constructing these shelters in the safe houses that will be popping up around the country and world. For more information on zero-emission Tempest shelters, visit the website www.thematrixdeciphered.com. Defeating non-lethal ads, PEP, and rubber bullets. I am a scientist for civilian defense, not to be confused with the Department of Defense. I help protect the people from the Department of Defense. Protests and demonstrations have become painful and dangerous for those who still wish to have a democracy. Here are some defenses against the tyrannical federal forces. A mylar umbrella would deflect some of the microwave and laser energy necessary to create these pain weapons and stun weapons. The umbrella could also serve as a shield for the water guns used at demonstrations too. With a Kevlar backing, the umbrellas would also serve to stop 22 caliber bullets. Earplugs will prevent nausea created by ultrasonic acoustic weapons. Infrasound weapons can be lessened by sound-absorbing anechoic cones. If you are protesting peacefully, like at the World Trade Organization conference in Seattle, expect rubber bullets will be used, and bring your motorcycle helmet and thick leather garb to protect yourself from the few over-exuberant bouncers, accidentally accepted to the police academy, who are unable to professionally control their emotions. Stupid alien tricks. We are shooting a sonic bullet at you and hitting your brain and heart. Houses creak and make noises which the zombieloids hear through your ears. Did you hear that? We missed. Now we are going to shoot you in the brain, which does lots of damage. One of the cloners presses their finger on their head. Did you feel that? Stupid aliens. Brainwave tracking evasion. A possible secondary reason drugs are such a concern in our society is not just the detriment to the individuals that become addicted and thereby are unable to take care of themselves, or even the secondary crimes that take place because of the poverty associated with drug use and the desire to reacquire a particular mental state. It could be that people are identified by a brainwave signature and tracked in this way as described by patent number. Drugs may change the brainwaves enough that their unique brainwave signature can't be recognized by TAMI for tracking, or monitored by the echelon-like system for thoughts with current artificial intelligence capabilities. It might also be that the signal that every human in the world adapts to and integrates in their neural network as a sixth sense is unlearned, and they therefore fall off the global human surveillance grid and outside TAMI's influence. So creating a scarecrow by recording and replaying your brainwaves on a dummy might confuse one type of tracking technique. Pain weapons, fear of pain, of death, not of death itself. The only thing we have to fear is fear itself. FDR's first inaugural address. Franklin D. Roosevelt. Cowards die many times before their deaths. The valiant never taste of death but once. Shakespeare. The next generation psychic warfare. Denial of service attack. The developers of this biocommunications weapon have approached the hacking of the human mind. See Science Channel special Spies Are Us, just like a rogue computer hacker. Every analogous computer hacker's method has been tested, developed, and practiced on worldwide citizens. The denial of service attack, as it is termed, has brought down major computer companies' websites like Amazon and even Microsoft. It works by a hacking, then zombifying thousands of computers anywhere in the world. They then begin to request information from the website simultaneously and thereby bring the web servers to their knees, and therefore they cannot service real customers. In the equivalent hacking of the human mind, several connected minds or just their voices piped into a target. Either they use their own voices or transform them into the target's voice. The target begins to have difficulty filtering all the questions and conversations, especially if they are using his own internal sounding voice. It brings his productivity and clarity of thought to a new low level. A human cannot survive under this condition, either to maintain a job or operate as a military leader. Trojan horse. A Trojan horse is a computer program that acts just like any other useful utility but has malicious code inside that is also run at some specific time. The comparison to the CIA MKUltra programming of assassins or Manchurian candidates is very appropriate. This is the programming I went through. They haven't changed much of it since the 1950s, so I won't detail here. But the idea is to take a sociable, well-educated, connected person and create hypnotic or EEG clone trigger signals that will cause the person to commit some action at a specific time once the Manchurian is in the proper social setting. See the appendix for a CIA document that described practicing on American politicians. Ironically, the test of whether they succeed will happen on June 14, 17 of 2006. I am meeting with many members of Congress and their assistants to discuss this topic and what can be done to stop the military's practice on the United States citizens. I'm not worried. If you knew the incompetence of the United States government and military as well as I do, they have a 99% chance of failure. Tripwires and unique hashing IDs. Know thyself and you will have an immunity to many kinds of mind hacks. This good advice is equivalent to a diagnostic algorithm used to detect hacks called tripwires. If a program is altered by a virus, the unique encrypted hashing ID is changed. If you notice that any of your perspectives and capabilities have changed, suspect an infection. This can be the psychotic eye movement frequency, a perspective change like disassociation, or emotional associations to ideas, words, or people, for example. The neural programming techniques have become quite sophisticated, but I will only consult to other countries about the details to help them protect their populations and sovereignty. The fitness function of countries' political systems must play out without cheating and using these very anti-democratic methods to cheat. Only by allowing the search space of different possibilities of optimal governmental forms to play out without influence can the world determine truly what works best. Worms and viruses. Worms in the cognitive modeling world are implemented through memes. Memes are introduced to the populations or subcultures through social information streams. This can take the form of TV advertising, programming, or movies. It can even be an infiltrated group of agents that can introduce a worm. Cultural mind viruses and worms are difficult to distinguish. I practiced non-malignant mind viruses, which I coined pings of social networks by creating interesting truths or misinformation to see how far in social networks the information would travel. Any fad or common belief that spreads can be included in this category. One very popular belief is that if people hear voices without electronic devices, that they are crazy. Another could be a detrimental fad like the gangster look with baggy pants that begin at the knees. If you are a gangster, you would want to be able to run away from your crimes, and this fad clearly prevents that. Buffer overflow. Another very successful but complex hacking method is called a buffer overflow. In computer science, this means that the input stream overflows the memory space allocated to input and begins to write into the executable space. In mind hacking, it is done with levels of logic and information. Information is presented in such a way as to require the target mind to maintain a large set of logical inferences in order to determine the truth of the statements. It is like a chess game where you need to think many level deep and remember all the possibilities. If you can't, you will make a logical deduction or inference error and consume that piece of information as truth. There are many other forms of hacking that are practiced, but that gives you a good idea how the games work. Now, let's look at the defense and how to hack the hacker's mind. In an EEG cloning lock, the attacker has the advantage of anonymity, surprise, and brainwave filters that shield some of their thoughts from the cloner to the target. However, every system has flaws and the filters are far from perfect. Learning to extract information from the attacker can be just as effective as their interrogation techniques, both traditional and non. Traceroute is a utility to try to find out where the hacker is located. It can be difficult because hackers can bounce their information stream off many different computers all around the world before reaching the target. Similarly, the scatter stealth radar used is almost undetectable in terms of direction of source and due to synthetic aperture and beam steering techniques. However, accessing the attacker's mind and tripping them up with emotion and verbal cues can be done. In addition, traditional internet research pays off immediately. The psychic war games will increase in complexity. Since the EEG cloner attacker, if human, is linked to the perceived target brain signals, it is possible to use cognitive model simulations to mimic the supposed target's brain waves and in fact reprogram the attacking human or simulated model accordingly. This is hacking the hacker's mind. This is theory only. The United States and Russia do not have this capability yet. See Scarecrow Tactics for more detail. Hacking the eye tracking interface. Knowing how the eye tracking interface is laid out would allow a counter attack by forcing the heterodynous eyes to various menu points. Remember, during cloning and heterodyning, the attacker is usually more susceptible to your brain amplifications than you are to theirs. It is a two-way street. Denial of service attack. One of the duties of a psychic warrior or the simulated ELISA cognitive model sentence stimulator is to be able to endlessly engage the target in useless banter. The strategy is to be as controversial as possible. Try this technique with someone you know. By being offensive and disagreeable, people have difficulty walking away from the conversation or remaining silent. With enough practice, you will have developed the most important skill in a voice-to-skull electronic harassment attack. This method using microwave hearing effect and synthetic telepathy will degrade the productivity of the target enormously and, as one treacherous colonel put it, drive a target crazy with voices. Imagine if you can, a conversation that you cannot walk away from, a conversation where any voice pattern can be mimicked, even your own internal voice, and where the urge to respond is amplified. This kind of attack mimics the symptoms of schizophrenia exactly. Mental illness is how the military has traditionally and illegally disposed of undesirables such as disobedient soldiers or whistleblowers, and now in ever-increasing numbers, the randomly selected weapons test subjects. The movie V is for Vendetta isn't all that far from the truth. Enemies of the state are being created by the tens of thousands due to torture and government experimentation in this country and worldwide. We have been wronged in the worst way. Nothing short of a new transparent government ruled by the people is our goal. The movie reminded me of my own brutal torture by the government. The population has been electromagnetically and psychologically doped by the shadow government. They have been placed in a system that keeps them complacent and focused on the unimportant details of their existence. The devil is in the details. I offer thanks on behalf of the true Americans to the NSA agents that proudly and rightly came forward to alert the United States population of infractions of privacy ordered by a president who can't even recite the Constitution. Where did our standards go? To make sure that the American public couldn't prove he was a silver spoon-fed glide-by, he had the Secret Service confiscate his academic records at Yale.